Okay, so I'm just grabbing a quick, like, 808 sound from a drum machine in my studio. We'll just input that into Ableton, and then I'm going to load up the nasty channel, Okay, now you can see on the nasty channel, the layer is sizzle, and you can affect the amount of sizzle that you want to add on top of that 808 sound. Right now, it's about 30%. And you can move that up and down and as much sizzle as you want to add. Well, let's change it over to carbonation. These are all sounds I recorded on my analog stuff here at the studio. You can see some of it behind me. I made each one of these layers, so they're all like different things. And you can change the pitch of the layer. So even though it's noise, you can still change the pitch, and then you can change the decay of the layer. This is more important on like a breakbeat, but on this sound, you know, how long do you want the tail of the top sound to be? Then you can high pass the sound. You can low pass the sound, filter it down. Then you can add however much warmth you want to the original sound. That's kind of just like body. It's a little bit subtle on this plugin. And then this is the grandmaster, the drive knob. This is where all the magic happens at the end of the chain. The drive really makes everything super freaking nasty. As you will hear, it's just, you can do any kind of like fizzy, twizzy, trap 808. You can really make it lo-fi, hi-fi, super fizzed out, like super gritty, super like distorted, effed up. These are just all the presets that I have made for it. And yeah, just keep tweaking. I just keep tweaking the sound around and just pushing that drive, make it sound just super disgusting. This is one of my favorite names of patches, the reindeer fat. Anyway. Okay, this time we have a this beat that I'm making with S-Fam. So let's see what this sounds like with what we got going on here now. That's the sub. That's supporting the mids. Okay, here's the mids. And okay, let's pull a nasty channel onto the mid-range. And then let's play the mid-range with nothing. Here we go. And then let's just hear it. Right away, you're going to hear a change. Got to loop this up so we don't have to keep going back to it. Right, you hear that sizzle layer just pop right on, right? It just gives it some... I'm changing the pitch. I'm changing the decay. I'm pushing it up here, giving it some drive and some body. And then I'm going to see if I need to high pass or low pass. Probably not on this. Just want to get that noise pitch in that right region and then mount. And then don't add too much decay there because you don't want it to just be sloppy over the edges of the bass sound. And then let's hear it. Oh yeah, with that sub. It's totally different, right? Let's A-B. Here, we'll try a couple other sounds first, sorry. Just try to nail it into a, like, something. Now listen. Yeah, see, that's cool. But that's cooler. Yeah, the dog hearing, that one freaks me out. Okay. Yeah, listen, you can push it hard. Like, you don't want to get too much gain in there, but you can push it all the way to where it's totally freaking out. Anyway, you can hear it's dramatically changing the vibe of this patch and giving it some life. And you can almost lo-fi it if you Yeah, you see what I'm saying? Ooh. There it is without. There it is with. This is if you like that kind of grit sound. Like, it's not that modern sounding. It sounds like a fucking... And okay, so here we're going to put in a breakbeat into Ableton, and I'm going to show you just how dramatic this can be on drums. This plugin is so sweet for like old breaks. You can make them sound even older, or you can really sweeten them up and make them sound super popping. I got this breakbeat up, and I'm going to open up a channel. Nasty channel. I'm gonna open up a nasty channel, son. Then we're gonna turn on the nasty channel. There we go. We're gonna bring up the sizzle layer a little bit, bring up the warmth, give us a little body, a little decay there, and then push that drive circuit up a little bit, and you can hear it's kind of already popping a little better than just that bland breakbeat that we had in before. You can use this on here. Here's it off. And then back on. You can hear it really gives it some life. You can change the layer to radio here. Pitch that down. Let's try rattlesnake. Yeah, change the pitch. I like to keep the decay down on breaks. So it's just not like flashing around. Then I push that drive up. And you see it just makes it more modern sounding. There's off. I mean, that sounds like a break that could be in a track from like modern times instead of 1992. We also have this weird oscillator section where you can put like a saw wave in there. This is a little bit more experimental if you want to get funky. I'll make a whole nother video on these oscillators. They can get real wild, but you can just hear kind of like some of, you can get creative with this plugin, let's just say that. And honestly, I'm not pushing this as hard as I should be, but if you want to get this thing to go like death metal, you can do it. It's not my vibe usually, but if you want some hard ass distortion, this thing will go there. Let's hear it off. So as you can see, that breakbeat's really getting filled out. It's like, pull that drive up. That drive circuit is so dope. Little decay on there. It just grabs the transients and then just puts the decay on there. You pick the sound on the layer, pitch it up or down, see what the decay is. You can high pass it out, low pass, see there it is. We had it all low passed out. Yeah, this sounds snappy. There you go, that's what we started with, right? I mean, step into the future, fool. All right, cool. That's the nasty channel. I mean, that's just scratching the surface on what this thing can do. Stupid, dirty. If you want to see more videos, just leave them in the comments. We'll set up a section of the website where you can make feature requests. I think that's a good idea. Anyway, I'm Barclay or Claude, whatever you want to call me, and that's the new plugin. Yeah!